headphones. Master volume. I think I just fucked something up. Full captions. Back. Back. Begin. Alright. Here we go. Here we go.
This is the story of a man named Stanley. Stanley worked for a company in a big building where he was employee number 427. Employee number 427's job was simple. He sat at his desk in room 427 and he pushed buttons on a keyboard. Orders came to him through a monitor on his desk, telling him what buttons to push, how long to push them, and in what order. This is what employee 427 did every day of every month of every year. And although others might have considered it soul-rending, Stanley relished every moment that the orders came in, as though he had been made exactly for this job. And Stanley was happy.
Aw, Stanley.
And then one day, something very peculiar happened. Something that would forever change Stanley. Something he would never quite forget. He had been at his desk for nearly an hour when he realized that not one single order had arrived on the monitor for him to follow. No one had showed up to give him instructions, call a meeting, or even say hi. Never in all his years at the company had this happened, this complete isolation. Something was very clearly wrong. Shocked, frozen solid, Stanley found himself unable to move for the longest time. But as he came to his wits and regained his senses, he got up from his desk and stepped out of his office.
Wait, what the fuck, dude? This is like so trippy right now. Wait, hold on. What are the controls, guys? I gotta check it out. Keyboard, mouse, edit keys. WSD control, use item, mouse 1. Wait, that's it? That's it? Control mouse 1. Okay. I'll take it.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Hold on, guys. I got you. Hold. I think it's because my shit's on, 120 hertz. Let me do double buffer for now. There's right, tell me if it does it now. One second, guys. Maybe it'll be better. Screen tearing? Anything? I might need to do a triple buffer. Are we good? I need a we good if we good. Alright, we're good. Actually, the game looks so much better.
No matter how hard Stanley looked, he couldn't find a trace of his co-workers.
Okay. Okay. Interesting. Alright, I can close that door, open it. I can shut off the monitor. Levolution. I can't open that.
Stanley went around touching every little thing in the office, but it didn't make a single difference, nor did it advance the story in any way.
Fuck you, man. I'm trying. Do you just want me to go down the hall?
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
But, I mean, you can't just say that. No, fuck you, I'm going right.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
All you guys are saying right. Yo, we think alike. I like it, guys. I'm a fan. Dude, these are like all the employee numbers.
Ah, yes. Truly a room worth admiring. It had really been worth the detour after all, just to spend a few moments here in this immaculate, beautifully constructed room.
Dude, it is
Stanley
really
simply
pretty.
Stood here, drinking it all in.
I actually like the blue color, I'm not gonna lie. Like, this is an awesome
but
room.
But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Should I just not listen to him? I mean, I could, but I can also go straight. I think I'm gonna say, fuck it, I'm gonna go straight, dude. I gotta be rebellious.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
This game's fucking hilarious right now. Do not jump from the cargo lift while it is in motion will cause death. Penalty for misuse of cargo lift, 1,000. Penalty for jumping off the cargo lift, 5,000.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not. I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time. There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley. Someone you've forgotten about. Please, stop trying to make every decision by yourself. I'm not asking for me, I'm asking for her.
Whoa, who's her?
This is it, Stanley. Your chance to redeem yourself. To put your work aside. To let her back into your life. She's been waiting.
Wait. Something sketchy, dude. Wait, hold on. Why is this a dark room, man? Fuck that! Whatever.
That's her, Stanley. You need to be the one to do this. To reach out to her. If you can truly place your faith in another, then pick up the phone.
Should I pick it up? It's up to you guys. I don't think I should. But I'm curious. I'm really curious. What the fuck?
Oh, Stanley, is that you? Hold on, sweetie. Sorry to keep you waiting. I'm just pulling the bread out of the oven. All right. Okay, there we go. All right, now, I want you to come in and tell me all about
your damn boy.
Gotcha. Oh, come on. Did you actually think you had a loving wife who'd want to commit their life to you?
Oh, my God.
I'm trying to make a point here, Stanley. I'm trying to get you to see something. Come inside. Let me show you what's really going on here.
Fuck this guy, dude.
This is a very sad story about the death of a man named Stanley.
Whoa. Good morning, employee 427. Press Z on your keyboard. Wait, can I not press Z? Is that like a choice? I don't think I can do anything else, so fuck it.
Stanley is quite a boring fellow. He has a job that demands nothing of him, and every button that he pushes is a reminder of the inconsequential nature of his existence.
Are you fucking serious? Like, I feel like such a bitch right now, like, if I do it, but I can't do anything else. I can't even jump, dude. God.
Look at him there, pushing buttons, doing exactly what he's told to do. Now he's pushing a button. Now he's eating lunch. Now he's going home. Now he's coming back to work. One might even feel sorry for him, except that he's chosen this life.
Are you serious, man? Oh my God.
But in his mind, in his mind, he can go on fantastic adventures. From behind his desk, Stanley dreamed of wild expeditions into the unknown, fantastic discoveries of new lands. It was wonderful. And each day that he returned to work was a reminder that none of it would ever happen to him.
Press 6 to watch TV. Yo, Gear said think out of the box, alright? Wait. Like, dude, the only thing you can do is mouse click on shit. So, I mean, I'm pretty sure you're forced to do this stuff, you know? Yeah. Yeah.
And so he began to fantasize about his own job.
Wait!
First, he imagined that one day while at work, he stepped up from his desk to realize that all of his co-workers, his boss, everyone in the building had suddenly vanished off the face of the earth.
Oh yeah, you're right.
The thought excited him terribly.
Please press E to spend time with the boys. Alright, I won't press it. I'll just press, like, 2. Z. Nah, dude. It doesn't do shit. You have to press E. I just hit everything on my keyboard, bro. Even R. Yeah, you have to do it. Yep.
So, he went further. He imagined that he came to 2 open doors and that he could go through either. At last, choice. It barely even mattered what lay behind each door. The mere thought that his decisions would mean something was almost too wonderful to behold.
Please press E to prepare dinner. I can't leave. I'm a prisoner! I'm a prisoner! Yeah, dude, you gotta do it.
As he wandered through this fantasy world, he began to fill it with many possible paths and destinations. Down one path lay an enormous round room with monitors and mind controls. And down another was a yellow line that weaved in many directions. And down another was a game with a baby. And he called it the Stanley Parable.
The name of the game. Please press F to tell your kids a story. I don't know what's going on right now. I'm confused.
It was such a wonderful fantasy. And so in his head, he relived it again. And then again, and again, over and over, wishing beyond hope that it would never end, that he might always feel this free. Surely there's an answer down some new path, mustn't there be? Perhaps if he played just one more time.
Press C to tell your wife you love her. Press all the other buttons. I gotta do it, fuck!
But there is no answer. How could there possibly be?
Oh,
in reality,
God.
All he's doing is pushing the same buttons he always has. Nothing has changed. The longer he spends here, the more invested he gets. The more he forgets which life is the real one.
Please press E to go to sleep. Dude.
And I'm trying to tell him this. That in this world, he can never be anything but an observer. That as long as he remains here, he's slowly killing himself. But he won't listen to me. He won't stop. Here, watch this. Stanley, the next time the screen asks you to push a button, do not do it.
But I was waiting. How long do you want me to wait? I'm streaming. No one wants to wait this long. I don't like this guy, though. He said don't do it, so I'm gonna fucking do it, bitch.
You see? Can he just not hear me? How can I tell him in a way that he'll understand that every second he remains here, he's electing to kill himself? How can I get him to see what I see? How can I make him look at himself?
Please press Q to question nothing. I'm gonna question nothing, dude. I don't care.
I suppose I can't. Not in the way I want him to. But I don't make the rules. I simply play to my intended purpose, the same as Stanley. We're not so different, I suppose. I'll try once more to convey all this to him. I'm compelled to. I must. Perhaps, well, maybe this time he'll see. Maybe this time. And I tried again. And Stanley pushed a button. And I tried again. And Stanley pushed a button. And I tried.
Wait, what? Wait, what? Did I, like, lose or something? So there's multiple endings? Okay, so we'll do different things this time.
All his co-workers were gone.
Oh my god.
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
I'll do what he says this time, alright? We're gonna do what he says this time, alright? We're gonna go to the left door.
When Stanley came to a set of 2 open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Okay. No, we went right last time. You said right then left. You can't really do that because it closes the door behind you, right? Hold on. Unless I can open it. Nope, you can't do that. Yeah, there's multiple endings, I guess. Someone said, like, this game is... I don't know. Let's just follow his instructions.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
How to solve a dispute with a coworker. Let it ball up inside you. Take it out passive-aggressively. Oh, God. Using slides to assure employees that everything is okay. Make sure your slide has a slick blue graphic in the header and throw some bevel on all the text. This will... God damn it. Everyone is unique. Most of all. Okay. Okay. I want to see the how to get fired. Number of slides on this slide. Charts, slides, charts, and slides. Wow. Bi-quarterly post review. Fucking... What do people want? Okay. To do, synergize core value expenditure, shift global market parade? Monetize free to play. Free to play. Alright, whatever, let's go. Whoa. Really?
Stanley stepped into the broom closet, but there was nothing here, so he turned around and got back on track.
No, there's gotta be something. Fuck you.
There was nothing here. No choice to make.
Nope.
No path to follow. Just an empty broom closet.
I'm gonna stay here.
No,
I'm gonna stay here.
Still be here.
I'm gonna stay here, alright? We're gonna wait.
It was baffling that Stanley was still just sitting in the broom closet. He wasn't even doing anything. At least if there was something to interact with, he'd be justified in some way.
Nothing.
As it is, he's literally just standing there doing sweet FA.
No, just wait. Hold.
Are you really still in the broom closet? Standing around doing nothing? Why? Please offer me some explanation here. I'm genuinely confused.
Hold.
You do realize there's no choice or anything in here, right? If I'd said Stanley walked past the broom closet, at least you would have had a reason for exploring it to find out. But it didn't even occur to me because literally this closet is of absolutely no significance to the story whatsoever. I never would have thought to mention it.
Fuck you. Hold!
Maybe to you this is somehow its own branching path. Maybe when you go talk about this with your friend, you'll say, "Oh, did you get the broom closet ending? The broom closet ending was my favorite." I hope your friends find this concerning.
Oh my God. Fuck you. I hate this guy, man.
Stanley was fat and ugly and really, really stupid. He probably only got the job because of a family connection. That's how stupid he is.
Oh my God.
That all the drug money. Also, Stanley is addicted to drugs and hookers.
Dude, he's getting so pissed at me. Hold!
Well, I've come to a very definite conclusion about what's going on right now. You're dead. You got to this broom closet, explored it a bit, and were just about to leave because there's nothing here, when a physical malady of some sort shut down your central nervous system and you collapsed on the keyboard. Well, in a situation like this, the responsible thing is to alert someone nearby so as to ensure that your body is taken care of before it begins to decompose.
Oh my God.
Hello? Anyone who happens to be nearby? The person at this computer is dead. He or she has fallen prey to any number of your countless human physiological vulnerabilities. It's indicative of the long-term sustainability of your species. Please remove their corpse from the area and instruct another human to take their place at the computer, making sure they understand basic first-person video game mechanics and filling them in on the history of narrative tropes in video gaming, so that the irony and insightful commentary of this game is not lost on them. All right, when you've done that, just step out into the hallway.
No, hold. Anything? Is it over? He gave up? Hold. Hold. I don't trust this piece of shit. I do not trust him. He's just waiting longer. He is waiting longer. You won the game? Dude, there's gotta be something. There's definitely something. One minute. One more minute. Open and close the door. 1 minute and then we'll do that. Hold on. Okay, fine.
Ah, second player. You too. Unbelievable. I'm at the mercy of an entire species of invalids. Perhaps there's a monkey nearby you can hand the controls to. A fish? Fungus? Look, you can hammer out the details. I'm not particularly picky. I'll just be waiting for when you're ready to pick up the story again.
Hold! Hold! This game is retarded, dude. I love it. One more time. I don't think he's gonna budge. Okay, I think we're good, guys. I don't think they have any more. Nah, dude. Alright, well, hold on. Nope. Let's go. Ooh!
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Let's do it. Let's follow it, alright? We're gonna follow it, okay? Follow it. Holy fuck, boss's office? Jesus, dude. Talk about an office, dude. Executive bathroom? Alright. Okay. Yo, check the computer, man. Fucking i7 4770K in there. Dude, this office.
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this. What dark secret was being held from him? What he could not have known was that the keypad behind the boss's desk guarded the terrible truth that his boss had been keeping from him. And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number. 2845.
I'm curious.
But of course, Stanley couldn't possibly have known this.
I'm... 2845? Wait, hold on. Do you guys see that little thing that pops up? Am I, like, trying to do something
here? Stanley just sat around twiddling his thumbs. Trying to input anything on the device was useless, since he could never possibly know that the combination was 2845.
I don't want to do it. What do you guys think? I'm thinking don't do it.
2845.
I don't think I should do it. I'm not going to do it. Are you guys serious? Do it? What if I type in wrong numbers? Okay, fine.
But it turns out that the panel's emergency override kicked in, and the door just opened all by itself.
Okay.
And Stanley got the hell along with the story. Well, whoop-de-do.
Okay. 2845. Yeah, we good? Oh, okay. I put it in anyways. I don't know if that changed anything, because it opened and I put it in anyways. Uh-oh. It's like a coal mine shaft. Yo, hold on. Is anything over here? Alright, let's go, man. Dude, this is, like, insane. This game is fucking crazy. Oh! Here we go, here we go.
Descending deeper into the building, Stanley realized he felt a bit peculiar. It was a stirring of emotion in his chest, as though he felt more free to think for himself, to question the nature of his job. Why did he feel this now, when for years it had never occurred to him? This question would not go unanswered for long.
Dude, my boss's secret, what could it be?
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
Okay, I'm not gonna walk through it. Well, okay, hold on. It says escape right there. Chat room, I can't do this without you. Left or forward? Left or forward? It's like escape is written. I'm thinking left, personally. Hold? Hold? Okay, majority is saying forward from the looks. Nah, man, we can't hold. We can't hold. He's not saying anything. Alright, we're going forward. We're going forward.
The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens. What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Did he have the strength to find out?
Oh, shit. Wait, can I go back from here? Hold on. You guys said think out of the box, alright? Never mind. God damn it. What if I jump off? You can't jump in this game. Plot twist. Can I fall here? No, you can't. No, you can't. No, you can't. We're gonna do it. That's the camera control. Wait, is that what I gotta press? Wait, what? Can I turn these on? Alright, fuck it. Yo, I mean, I guess.
Now the monitors jumped. Whoa! Their true nature revealed. Each bore the number of an employee in the building, Stanley's co-workers. The lives of so many individuals reduced to images on a screen. And
NSA.
Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place. Where freedom meant nothing.
Wait, hold on. Can you press buttons twice? No. Bro, this is like NSA headquarters, I agree. This is fucking insane. Fired! Oh my god! 104, RIP. Okay.
This mind control facility, it was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true. Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly?
Dude, shit is about to go down.
No, he refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control? Never! It was unthinkable, wasn't it? Was it even possible? Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world?
Wait, what was so special about 427?
The heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions. Happy, or sad, or content. Walking, eating, working. All of it monitored and commanded from this very place. And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another human life. For he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
No, I know 427 is my number, but I looked at it when I was going in. There was nothing special about it. I didn't see anything. Oh, I don't know. Mind control status offline. Wait, there's so many buttons. Should I press one? One says 10. I don't know what the fuck the other one does. Yo, whatever. Press that. This? There's a big red button. I am not pressing that shit. No. Unless I need to press that and then everything works. No. Hold on. Yeah, I think I do have to press the red button. Whoa, hold on. What is this? There's buttons everywhere. Mind controls idle awaiting input. Fine, jeez. You guys are so whiny, Jesus. I can't even fucking press it, dude. Hold on, I'm gonna explore. Screw you guys. Click the numbers 427. No, they're all 10, bro. And the others have, like, weird icons. That's the power button right there. Hold on, can I press that? Nah, I probably just need to go forward. Hold on. You can't open that shit. Console disabled. That just, like, blinded me. Oh, unless you're saying around the room. No, 1, 2, 5. No, hold on. Can I press these? Huh. What about this? I can't press it. House? Okay, let's go forward. Wait, can I go through here? No, let's go forward. Yeah, let's just go forward. I don't really know. I don't see anything crazy about this room. There's just a bunch of different symbols and shit. Alright, let's go. Oh god. Oh shit! Mind controls, idle, awaiting input. Oh, here we go.
When at last he found the source of the room's power, he knew it was his duty, his obligation, to put an end to this horrible place and to everything it stood for.
Obviously, I put it on. But what if I just, like, press off? It's already... Yeah, like, do you want me to just shut it off? I could. Alright, fine. Jeez.
Oh, Stanley. You didn't just activate the controls, did you? After they kept you enslaved all these years, you go and you try to take control of the machine for yourself. Is that what you wanted?
Holy shit!
Oh, Stanley, I applaud your effort, I really
do. No, fuck you!
There's only so much that machine can do. You were supposed to let it go, turn the controls off, and leave. If you want to throw my story off track, you're going to have to do much better than that. I'm afraid you don't have nearly the power you think you do. For example, and I believe you'll find this pertinent, Stanley suddenly realized he had just initiated the network's emergency detonation system. In the event that this machine is activated without proper DNA identification,
oh my God.
Nuclear detonators are set to explode, eliminating the entire complex.
Oh,
how
shit.
Long until detonation, then? Let's say, 2 minutes. Ah, now this is making things a little more fun, isn't it, Stanley? It's your time to shine. You are the star. It's your story now. Shape it to your heart's desires. Oh, this is much better than what I had in mind. What a shame we have so little time left to enjoy it. Mere moments until the bomb goes off. But what precious moments each one of them is. More time to talk about you.
I don't know.
About me. Where we're going. What all this means. I barely know where to start. What's that? You'd like to know where your co-workers are? A moment of solace before you're obliterated? All right, I'm in a good mood. You're gonna die anyway. I'll tell you exactly what happened to them. I erased them. I turned off the machine. I set you free. Of course, that was merely in this instance of the story. Sometimes when I tell it, I simply let you sit there in your office forever, pushing buttons endlessly and then dying alone.
The red button.
Other times, I let the office sink into the ground, swallowing everyone inside, or I let it burn to a crisp. I have to say this, though. This version of events has been rather amusing. Watching you try to make sense of everything and take back the control wrested away from you, it's quite rich. I almost hate to see it go. But I'm sure whatever I come up with on the next go-around will be even better. My goodness, only 34 seconds left.
I want to see what happens when the time runs out. You know what? He's bullshitting. It's a bluff.
I'm going to put some extra time on the clock. Why not?
No. We're waiting.
Precious additional seconds, Stanley.
We're going to wait. We're going to wait. We're going to wait.
Oh, dear me. What's the matter, Stanley? Is it that you have no idea where you're going or what you're supposed to be doing right now? Or did you just assume when you saw that timer that something in this room was capable of turning it off? I mean, look at you. Running from button to button, screen to screen, clicking on every little thing in this room. These numbered buttons. No, these colored ones. Or maybe this big red button. Or this door. Everything, anything, something here will save me.
No.
Why would you think that, Stanley? That this video game can be beaten? Won? Solved? Do you have any idea what your purpose in this place is? Stanley, you're in for quite a disappointment. But here's a spoiler for you. That timer isn't a catalyst to keep the action moving along. It's just seconds ticking away to your death.
Nope, he's bullshitting.
You're only still playing instead of watching a cutscene because I want to watch you for every moment that you're powerless. To see you made humble.
Nope.
This is not a challenge. It's a tragedy. You wanted to control this world, that's fine. But I'm going to destroy it first, so you can't.
He's bluffing.
Take a look at the clock, Stanley. That's 30 seconds you have left to struggle. 30 seconds until a big boom and then nothing.
Bullshit.
No end here, just you being blown to pieces. Will you cling desperately to your frail life, or will you let it go peacefully? Another choice. Make it count, or don't. It's all the same to me, all a part of the joke. And believe me, I will be laughing at every second of your inevitable
life. Bullshit.
From the moment we fade in until the moment I say, happily ever up.
Oh shit, wait, did it actually happen? Wait. Aww. He wasn't bullshitting, dude! Dude, I was so certain that he was bullshitting, man. I was fucking certain he was bullshitting, alright? That guy is such a troll, you know? Yeah. We told you. Fuck you guys. You guys have seen people play the game. I don't care. Gone. I'm not reading chat.
Stanley Spoiler heaven. To the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
We're gonna go right and unplug and not answer the phone or unplug it. That's what we're gonna do.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors,
fuck you, narrator. I've seen all this.
And Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge.
Yeah, I'm gonna do that, gaming.
Just to admire it. Wow. Yes. This room. But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
I went this way.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
And we're gonna unplug the phone. Let's do it.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not. I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time.
Jump off
this
to the right.
You've been neglecting, Stanley.
But I want to...
Someone you've forgotten about. What?
God damn
really?
It. Why do I listen to
I
you
was
guys?
I'm in the middle of something. Do you have zero consideration for others? Are you that convinced that I want something bad to happen to you? Why, I don't know how to convince you of this, but I really do want to help you, to show you something beautiful. Look, let me prove it.
Can we
let
go sub only?
That I'm on your
it's like
side.
Literally
give me a chance.
How can there be this many fucking retards in a chat room this fast? Like my mind is so blown right now. Have you guys already seen all the YouTube videos for what happens on every single fucking ending? Like, jeez, man. Backseat gaming up the
now,
ass.
Now listen carefully, this is important. Stanley walked through the red door.
Blue door.
Perhaps you misunderstood. Stanley walked through the red door.
What about this door? All right, yo, blue door. Let me see if it happens again. It doesn't.
I still don't think we're communicating properly. Stanley walked through the red door.
Nope.
All right, fine. Go ahead, Stanley. You want to know so badly what's out there? You want to find out what lies at the end of this road you've chosen? Well, don't let me stop you.
Nope, we're good. We're
you
good.
See, there's nothing here.
God damn it.
I haven't even finished building this section of the map because you were never supposed to be here in the first place. Broken rooms, exposed developer textures. Is this what you had wanted? Was it worth ruining the entire story I had written out specifically for you?
Oh my god.
Do you not think I put a lot of time into that? Because I did.
I'm sorry.
And in the end, it was all for nothing. Because this is what you wanted to see. Help me here, Stanley. Help elucidate these strange and unknowable desires of yours. What would have made this game better? What did you want to see? Vehicles?
No.
Skill trees? Work with me. You've given me
skill
absolutely
trees.
Nothing so far. Tell you what. Let me take a stab in the dark at a new design, and you can give me some feedback.
Oh, my God.
There we go. A
Whoa.
Third option. This already feels leaps ahead of where we were before. Go ahead, Stanley. Take it for a spin.
I'm so curious. I'm so curious right now. But what if I end up going to the right? I'm probably gonna die. I'll go for it, whatever.
Okay, I'm going to stop you there. Now, tell me about your experience with this new version. Would you say that the game benefited from allowing you more choices? Feel free to be honest. I'm looking for some real critical feedback here.
One.
A one? I mean, I can understand if you had reservations, you saw ways the game could be improved to more fully express itself mechanically and artistically, but a one? That's not even helpful. What am I supposed to do with that? But I guess it isn't my place to judge. Here, based on the data from your previous playthrough, I've compiled a new version. And to be perfectly candid, I think I've knocked it out of the park with this one. Let's take a look.
Whoa, dude. Worldwide leaderboard? What the fuck? Are these people actually on my friends list? It isn't, right? Oh wait, it's worldwide, isn't it? Did you know that 21.3% of players skipped the intro sequence? Only the worst 3% of players chose the blue door? Only the worst 3% of players chose the blue door? Fuck you! This is you?! You are, objectively ranked 9,328. This is bullshit. This is bullshit. Nope. 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 Nope, go back.
Now, would you say that competitive leaderboard helped you feel motivated to keep
no.
walking through doors?
Again, no!
Honest answers, please. Hey, I nearly forgot. I've got a prototype of a new game I've been working on, and now would be a lovely opportunity to give it some playtesting. You wouldn't mind taking a look at it, would you? Perfect. Let me boot it up.
Oh, shit.
In this game, the baby crawls left towards danger. You click the button to move him back to the right, and if he reaches the fire, you fail. It's a very meaningful game, all about the desperation and tedium of endlessly confronting the demands of family life. I think the art world will really take notice. But of course, the message of the game only becomes clear once you've been playing it for about 4 hours. So why don't you give it 4 hours of play to make sure it's effective? Be sure to keep notes on your experience.
I'm not gonna even do anything. I'm gonna let it die, straight up.
You heartless bastard. Did you do it because you hate babies or purely to spite me? Because if it's the latter, well, I don't know what to do. I'm completely out of ideas. I can't think of a single thing that might improve the experience for me. I'm not even going to try. I'm out. I'm done. It's over. Thank you for playing. Your input was extremely valuable.
Why?
Okay, since my game was so awful, why don't we play someone else's game? Just to ease the pain. Let's see. What do we have here?
The narrator's awesome.
Yes. This seems like it'll work. Let's give it a shot.
Dude, the narrator... What the fuck?
Well, Stanley, is this any better? At last, wow. The one thing you've always desired. A game I had absolutely nothing to do with.
What?
But is it enough? Tell me that, Stanley. Will it ever be enough? Well, I'll say this. I'm done making things for you. From now on, I will only create to fulfill a greater artistic purpose. Watch this, Stanley. I'm going to build a house. This will go here, no, here, and then... Let's see, what does it need? Yes, of course, and just to finish it all off, yes, it's complete. I made this, Stanley. Look at it. Gaze upon my work of art and feel ashamed at your own inadequacy. but you've only seen it from the outside. You've only gotten half the experience. Please, step inside and make yourself
I'm not gonna step inside. I'm playing this shit. Screw you, chat room. I'm not gonna step inside. Hold. Hold. You can't jump. You can't jump. Hold? Okay, well, yeah, I'll try closing the door. I can't, fuck.
Isn't it grand? Isn't it perfect? It could only be better if... Wait, that's it. We must rebuild it out of diamond. Diamond everything. Yes, yes, yes. Come along, Stanley. We have to go mining.
Dude, like, I don't want to play this shit. Wait, can I go back in his house? Hold on. Dude. Yo, I bet, like, Notch gave him permission to do this anyways, right? Yeah. This game is fucking awesome. Like, my mind is so blown right now.
It looks like it's going to get a bit dark. Have you brought a light?
No? I don't have shit, dude.
Oh, no. This is far more open-ended than I had in mind. I'm looking for something more narrow and linear. Something that makes you feel utterly irrelevant. This won't do at all. 1 out of 5. Even the diamonds couldn't save this one. Okay, new game.
That's awesome. I love it. I love it. Fucking shots fired. Wait, what?
Yes! I don't even know what this game is, but I love it. You, trapped in a glass box with no way out, listening to me talk. Oh, it's inspired. I couldn't have done it any better myself. What is this game even supposed to be? I can't figure it out. Okay, now I'm curious. Let's go find out what the hell this is.
Dude, like, holy shit, man. I love how they have all of this shit in it. It's crazy. It's insane, bro. Hold on, can I take some of this shit? I want to keep the radio with me. All right.
Oh, it's a puzzle. Critical thinking, Stanley. Your forte. Genius. No, actually, you know what? I think that's plenty. I really don't care much to see you stumble through any more of these games, and I highly doubt you're any wiser for the experience. Which is why, rather than continue to waste my time, I'm just going to leave you here. You can pretend you've beaten the game if it makes it any richer for you, but as for me, I've had enough.
What?
So, why don't you get cozy in this room, and if you have any grand revolutionary ideas for the perfect video game, you can just sit there and let it ball up inside you for all eternity. I don't need your advice. I don't need your ratings. And I certainly don't need the validation of a man whose job is to push buttons. I think I'll just go about my business, making meaningful cultural contributions to the world. and perhaps every now and then, I'll think back to a man named Stanley who was objectively wrong in every decision he ever made. The thought won't last long. Goodbye, Stanley. Good luck with your work, and I sincerely hope that everyone lives happily ever after.
Okay, I mean, all I can really do is jump. I can't go back. Nothing is clickable. I mean, alright, whatever. Holy shit. The Stanley Alpha Test, please rate your experience. The beta? Radio? Radio? Oh my god, it stopped! Dude, what the fuck? Hold on, follow the lighted area. There's gotta be some, like, lighted areas or something. This game is so fucked up. Like, I don't understand this shit at all. It's crazy. And I don't want to go down there. I might, like, die or some shit. Half-Life 3 confirmed. I don't know, like... I could just jump... Oh, wait, here we go. I mean... Hold on, am I, like, missing something to go? Everything is, like, a way off. If I jump off, will I die or something? What do you guys think? Do you see anything crazy? I think all I can do is really jump. Or, you know, not jump, fall off. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it, guys. Wait, I'm back at the offices. Holy shit! I'm back! Dude! I wanna look for my room number, 427. 427. Oh! Oh, shit. There's nothing. Yeah, it's the beta. This is basically the beta. What the fuck?
I wonder what he found. If what he wanted was to be the leading man in his own story, well, perhaps he's gotten it. Down in wherever he is right now. I wonder if he's happy with his choice. And if he's learned the heavy cost that comes with it. He'll understand soon what I was trying to tell him. He needs me. Someone who will wrap everything up at the end to make sense out of the chaos and the fear and the confusion. That's who I am. That is what I mean to this world. Oh, yes. Yes, I'll be back. There's no other way. Once this ends, after it all comes to a close, then I'll be back. The end will be here soon. Very soon. I can wait.
Wait, was that it?
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
Aww, okay, that was one of the endings.
Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Okay. I'm good. You can play this game like 50 fucking times and have different dialogue. It's insane, dude. Yeah, I noticed the papers as well. I was gonna say that too, but... You know, yeah, I noticed that too. But I think I'm good, you know? I'll do one more. Let's unplug the phone. Hold on. I wanna unplug the phone. We had a detour last time. Let me see. One more time. One more time.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, this was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. The lounge was sublime, a work of art. But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
No, we're gonna unplug the phone.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't fired years ago.
Okay.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not. I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time. There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley. Someone you've forgotten about. Please, stop trying to make every decision by yourself. Now, I'm not asking for me, I'm asking for her.
Okay, here we go,
Stanley, your chance to redeem yourself, to put your work aside, to let her back into your life. She's been waiting.
Okay.
That's her, Stanley. Oh, no, you can't. Did you just unplug the phone?
Yeah, bitch!
But that wasn't supposed to be a choice. How did you do that? You actually chose incorrectly? I didn't even know that was possible. Let me double check.
Wow.
No, it's definitely here, clear as day. Stanley picks up the phone. He's taken to his apartment where he finds his wife, and the two pledge themselves to one another. Music comes in, fade to white, roll credits. Not
Bullshit.
Picking up the phone is actually somehow an incorrect course of action. How is that even possible? None of these decisions were supposed to mean anything. I don't understand. How on earth are you making meaningful choices? What did you... Wait a second. Did I just see... No, that's not possible. I can't believe it. How had I not noticed it sooner? You're not Stanley. You're a real person.
Whoa!
I can't believe I was so mistaken. This is why you've been able to make correct and incorrect choices. And to think I've been letting you run around in this game for so long. If you'd made any more wrong choices, you might have negated it entirely. It's as though you completely ignored even the most basic safety protocol for real-world decision-making. Or did you not grasp the severity of the situation? Well, I won't have that kind of risk on my watch. I'm going to stop the game for a moment so we can educate you properly on safe decision-making in the real world. Please observe this helpful instructional video.
Choice. It's the best part of being a real person. But if used incorrectly, it can also be the most dangerous. For example, in this scenario, a hypothetical real person named Stephen has a choice. He could spend years helping improve the quality of life for citizens of impoverished third world nations. Or he could systematically set fire to every orphan living in a 30-kilometer radius of his house. Which choice would you make? Remember that unlike here, the real world makes sense, and at no time should you make a choice that does not conform to rational logic. If you find yourself speaking with a person who does not make sense, in all likelihood, that person is not real. Allow the person to finish their thought, then provide an excuse why you cannot continue talking. Turn to a partner and practice saying, "My goodness, is it 4:30? I'm supposed to be having a back sack and crack."
Huh? Whoa, what? Oh.
Excellent. Making choices on a regular basis is the best part to a healthy decision-making process. Most medical professionals recommend making at least 8 choices per day. Do you make more than 8? Less? And finally, if you begin to wonder if your choices are actually meaningful and whether you'll ever make a significant contribution to the world, just remember that in the vast infiniteness of space, your thoughts and problems are materially insignificant, and the feeling should subside. At this time, your instructor will guide you in an exercise to test and reinforce the material covered in this video.
Infield exercise. Oh, God.
Welcome back. You may have noticed that this room has begun to deteriorate as a result of narrative contradiction. But not to worry. Now that you're properly informed on good decision-making, we're going to revisit a choice you made just a few minutes ago and see what the correct thing to do would have been. This way, please.
Hold on. What if I... Can I go back? No. Dude! Wait, what? Hold on. Shit just went crazy.
Now that we know your choices are meaningful, we can't have you jumping off the platform and dying. Imagine the main character dying senselessly halfway through the story. That story would make no sense at all. We just need to get you home as soon as possible before the narrative contradiction gets any worse. Unfortunately, it seems this place is not well equipped to deal with reality.
Is this sending me all the way back? Can I actually go back? Huh? What the fuck? Okay. Dude, this game is wicked clever. I agree, man. Like, it's such a mindfuck, but it's awesome. Like, I'm literally...
Almost there. You'll take the door on the left, back to the correct ending, the story will have resolution once again, and you'll be home free in the real world.
Okay.
Now remember, all you need to do is behave exactly as Stanley would. That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first. I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine. All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
What if I go right again? Will something else happen? I kind of want to go right. Do it.
No! Why did you do that? Quickly, hurry back in the other direction. Perhaps we're not too late.
Hold. 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 I could go in and out. I could go in and out. I'll go in and out. I'll go in and out. Are you serious? You're forcing me? It's fucking forcing me, dude. I think it's forcing me. I need to do it. Yeah, it's forcing me, guys. It's forcing me. Or... I need to go to the right. I'm telling you guys. If I can just, like, trigger it. Wait, what?
Oh, it's ruined. I can't believe, after everything we talked about, that my story, you've destroyed my work!
Holy
Why?
Shit.
For what? What did you get out of that? What did you think was so special about seeing the game undone, left here like so much garbage? It's worthless now. And what am I supposed to do? Even if there were a way to continue, would it be worth it? To know that my story is now incorrect? How can I go back to that? I can't erase that knowledge. I'll have to live with it forever, reliving its impossibility forever. I couldn't live that way. Is it better to shut the game down entirely? To willingly destroy all of my work? I don't know. What's the answer? What do I do? What do I do? What do I... No, I have to. I have to shut the game down. I have to.
No.
I have to.
No. Oh, shit, dude. Is that game over? Oh, shit.
I'm here. I'm still here. Here in this pile of rubbish. With you. You. Who thought you were so clever. Now look where we are. My entire game is destroyed. It was the only thing in the world that was mine, and you've run it into the ground. What, did you think that would be funny? You just had to see? Didn't I impress upon you how important it was to be like Stanley? He actually knows how to do what I tell him to. He understands that if I say to do something, there's a damn good reason for it. That thought hadn't even occurred to you, had it? That there's a world outside of you? You're a child. Oh. My story. If you had just gone through the door on the left, you would have seen it. There was a whole underground facility. You would have destroyed it and been victorious. It would have been so perfect. I worked so hard on it. I tried so hard.
Wait, what?
Is behave exactly as Stanley would. That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first. I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine.
Wait, right. What?
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
What if I go right again? Will the same shit happen? I go left. Yeah, I think it would just repeat itself.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there. Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Okay, oh, can you go through here? No, you can't. Alright. Whoa! What the fuck? It changed! Dude, this game is fucking insane!
Sitting inside his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this, until he saw the door with a voice receiver next to it. Surely behind this door lay all the answers to his questions. And beyond all probability, he knew the passcode. He had seen it on his boss's computer just last week. Nightshark 115. Was this the code to open the door? Would it still work? There was only one way to find out. Stanley had been trained never to speak up, but now he would draw from within himself the courage to face the unknown. He drew a sharp breath and then spoke the code. Stanley spoke the code. Nightshark 115.
I think he opens
he
it automatically.
Into the receiver, right there on the wall.
I think he ends up opening it automatically. Dude, you can't.
Is there a problem? You didn't mishear me, did you? Please speak the code into the receiver. Otherwise, we can't get on with the story. This is a crucial step. Okay, fine, you're not gonna do it, but you know what? It's pretty humiliating to bring you this far, only for you to suddenly decide you have better things to do. I asked you for this one single thing, for your respect. The kind of respect Stanley shows for his choices. He knows what it means to take a story seriously. If you didn't want to see what I had to show you, then why did you come here? You had a choice, you know. You could have gone through the door on the right. You could have done whatever the hell you wanted over there. Why did you come this way? Speak.
What?
Say something to me. Explain yourself, you coward. When Stanley came to a set of
doors,
he entered the door on his left.
Wait,
Stanley?
What the fuck?
Hello? Is everything okay? Stanley, please. I need you to make a choice. I need you to walk through the door. Are you listening to me?
Huh?
Can you hear me? Is everything all right? Stanley, this is important. The story needs you. It needs you to make a decision. It cannot exist without you. Do you understand me? Whatever choice you make is just fine. They're both correct. You cannot be wrong here. We can work together. I'll accept whatever you do. I simply need you to take that step forward, please. Choose. Do something. Anything. This is more important than you can ever know. I need this. The story needs it. So, you hear me? Are you there? Are you listening to this? Stanley, are you there?
What the fuck?
Okay. It's okay, I can wait. You need time to decide. Time to make sure your choice is correct. That is the best choice. That's all right. I'll wait for you to decide what's the right thing to do.
He's so sad.
Take as much time as you need.
You can take it off of sub-only mode. Dude! Yeah, man, there's like 80 different things you can do in this game. There's like, either you can hold, you can go left, you can go right, you can listen to him or not listen to him. There's consequences here, consequences there. Like, it's insane. This game has so much replayability. Someone said they've spent already like 9 hours, you know? Didn't someone say that? Like 6 or 9 hours just going crazy and shit? Yeah. Dude, you put it back in sub-only mode. You didn't take it off, whoever just did that. It's subscribers off. That's what you gotta do. Yeah. Like, wow. Wow. I like this game a lot. It was $11 on Steam. Yeah. Dude, it's crazy, man. It's crazy. Fucking crazy. It's $11 on Steam. Yeah. Yep. It's cool. It's called the Stanley Parable. Parable, I think? Pretty cool, man. Pretty cool. Very unique game, man. I've never played something like that.